You know how it goes. You've been running around all day, time seems to slip away, and then you remember, your man's coming home hungry. Why not aim to please and make him his favorite, some marinara sauce? So, the first thing you want to do is grab your favorite pot. All right, set that on the stove. And we need 3 tablespoons of olive oil. I like to measure it out by eye. I don't like using measuring spoons that often. And that looks good. Set that at medium. Next thing we want to do is we need 1/2 onion. I like to use yellow onions personally, but you can use whatever you want. You don't have to chop it up too finely. It could be a little coarse, because you're making this for your man after all. All right. Let's throw that into the pot. Now that your olive oil is heated up, get the rest of those scraps. So the next thing you want to do is you want to grab your garlic. We need 6 cloves of garlic, okay? I'm gonna mince up your garlic. So I personally don't have a garlic mincer, and that's why I use my knife to chop it up really finely. Remember that when you put in your garlic, you don't want it to get burned because then your marinara is going to be ruined. Kind of like the sheets from my first honeymoon. Alright, so the next thing we want to do is we're going to have 8 large tomatoes. I want you to quarter these tomatoes, so just cut off the top of each of these and turn them over and just quarter them. Again, we're making a hearty marinara. Alright. Next thing you want to do is you want to grab your bay leaf. You just need one, okay? So just throw that in there. Let it simmer with the rest of the sauce. We're gonna get these tomatoes nice and soft. Not saucy. Sorry, I'm going too far. So the next part of the recipe calls for 1/2 glass of wine. oops. Well, I guess if you're trying to get loosey-goosey later, this helps. Just pour that into the pot. Make sure it's all simmering. Okay, so we're gonna want about 1 teaspoon of honey. Again, I don't measure anything out. So I'm gonna make this real sweet. So the next thing you wanna do is you wanna grab all of your herbs and your seasonings, all right? So the next thing is we're gonna grab some basil, dried basil. Throw in a dash of that. And then you wanna grab some oregano. Also, a dash of that. Now, salt is going to be the taste, okay? So we're gonna use some black pepper. Just a dash of that. And some crushed red pepper to get it a little bit spicy. Alright. Now that's all simmering together, getting all the juices flowing, getting everything tasting real nice, and making a really good marinara. Alright. Don't forget your fennel seed. Okay, that's 1/2 teaspoon of fennel seed. Alright. So you want to keep checking on your marinara and making sure that it's not burning at any point. Again, so we're keeping the heat on medium, and you want to make sure that all those juices are flowing into each other. And it's just about done. Honey, you're home early.
Hey, what are you making?
I'm making your favorite, marinara.
Oh my god, Oh, it's so good.
Just one bay leaf, that's all.
Put it down.
Do you remember how it looked on the table? Yep.
Good. And I was simmering. Wait. Okay. Now it's time for the red wine. Mm-hmm. It's kind of...
saucy swirl like that. How's that?
Good.
All of it or half of it?
All of it. Just remember, Michelle drinks the other part. And honey?
And just some honey. Gonna be this guy right here, just a little pinch of basil. Should I just go ahead and take a pinch like that?
Mm-hmm. Oregano.
We got the oregano right here. We'll take a big little pinch of that like that.
Salt.
Salt. I'm gonna take just an even a little bit smaller like that.
Black pepper.
Now we've got our black pepper.
Yeah, I'm actually after that. Fennel.
Then we've got our fennel seed.
A little bit slower.
Want me to redo that or?
No. And then crushed red pepper.
That's true.
That's it.
Is that okay?
Let's give you something like this.